head was blocked, but this wouldn't stop the great wizard, Amadeus. With his magic, he could lift objects. Amadeus could also conjure boxes out of thin air. The light moved through the forest, leading Amadeus further. Torn between fear and wonder, he followed. For there was trouble on the peasant farms. Creeping vines were taking over the fields.
A warlock must be behind this devilry. I'll find him and teach him a lesson with my sword. Luck. There'll be pumpkin pie for dinner tonight.
Pontius searched the farm, but saw no one there.
The nasties must have fled at the sight of me. Looks dangerous. Blasted weeds. I'll show you what for. I'm Pontius the Brave, and I won't fall in a battle with dandelions. The trine!
Pontius had never understood what exactly the trine did, but he knew that the artifact was there to help. And so Pontius felt happy. He couldn't think of a better quest than saving his kingdom. Late that night, Zoya...
Wait here. Wait here.
He was concealed in the shadows, hidden from the shimmering moonlight. lawyer passed through the town as quietly as a whisper. Then she saw a glimmering light moving on top of the old church. What are you doing here in the middle of the night? Not back to your old tricks and thievery.
Oh, there's a perfectly good explanation for this. Tell me, where are we going?
We don't really know yet. Something strange is going on.
A new venture. Shall we go then?
So the trine had come for the heroes, and the adventure was ready to begin. Amadeus worried for his family, while Pontius looked forward to their new quest. Zoya, of course, imagined what fabulous treasure they might find.